I'm gonna talk for a bit, so let's continue to eat and talk. It's all good. Blind Spot is often referred to as my show, Martin's show, and while I'd love to take credit for Blind Spot and its success, if I'm being honest, Blind Spot was really only ever my show for about 5 days in late June of 2014. When you start, you're all alone. I had an idea for a teaser, which I fleshed out into like a rough sense of the pilot, and then maybe thought what the series could be, and those 5 days, it was just the idea, and it was me. And then I widened the circle a bit. I called my great agent, David Stone, and said, do you think Greg Berlanti would be into this? And so we called up Echo at the time. I think only had like 6 TV shows on the air, so it was basically a nobody. And Greg's name was never on a single script, but his giant heart and his immeasurable smarts are omnipresent in the series forever. Greg and Sarah, my southern lawyer friend, who didn't know how it worked in TV, but in film did a little different. And Ryan took my little movie idea and made it stronger, made it cleaner, made it better. And then we widened the circle a little wider. We took it to our friends at Warner Brothers. Clancy Marlowe Jan made the pilot roadworthy. And he took it up to Susan Grosvenor's office, who, as always, you know, tugged at all the right strings, showing up the character work, certifying the pilot story. And then down the hall, we went to Peter Roth, you know, who's effusive embrace, both literally and figuratively. Gave us the courage to go out there and hopefully believe the network actually wanted this. Peter, you're a lion, you're a legend, you're one of the most passionate people I've ever met. Your friendship and unwavering support has meant the world to all of us. So, we took it out, and I still remember that NBC I felt like I maybe had insulted them all personally. That's how well I felt it went. But I was wrong. I was wrong. And they were amazing people. They gutted part of the idea that, to be honest, they were totally right about, and they championed it internally, and so we got the nod, got the thumbs up. Jen Salke said, go make a pilot, and we were off the buzz, and this is not something I really put onto a podcast, but I had never really made a pilot before, or really even been a part of one. So, again, I leaned so much on Greg during this process. Greg became my TV Jesus, because every time I would just ask, like, what would Greg do? And he knew we had to hire amazing people that can make up for my not-so-secret inexperience. Mark Pellington is a master filmmaker and artist. Put so much of himself into this show. Yeah. The reverberations of his presence are felt to this very day. And we got very lucky with the team we put together for the pilot. A handful of that crew has been with us ever since. The 100 Club, Chloe Smith, Sarah Rapp, Andrew Priestley, Chad McQuay, Sam Freshley, Mike Gansman, Blake Neely, Sherry Chung, Ryan P. Hayes, Jamie Marino, Steve Renato, Liza Richardson, Kevin Sutherland, Jennifer Foley, Chris Pozzavon, and Brendan Dahl. Brendan Dahl, who actually came up with the title Blind Spot, by the way. And our cast, not only our incredible guest cast, there have been thousands of you. It's insane how many casts we've employed, but our key cast, Sully, Jamie, Rob, Audrey, Ashley, eventually Ennis. What do you say? You're a wild, different, dysfunctional collection of luminous scene stealers. Your ability to imbue such incredible heart and humanity and grounding into this completely crazy, loud, fast, bonkers action machine blows me away every episode. People love watching you, our viewers feel deeply connected to you. The show would never work without you guys. So through sheer force of will, we made a pilot and we pulled it off and they green-lighted it and we hired a boatload of stupidly talented and deeply human writers and producers, many of whom stayed with us for the entire series. Rachel, Pete, Ryan, Ann, yes, led by Alex Berger, Christina Kim, Brendan Gall, not to mention our incredible LA support staff, especially Meg, who's been such a trusted ally for these past 4 years. Yes, Meg. And we lucked out like crazy with our current execs on the WB side. Melinda Haney, Maddie Horn, Maggie Gormley at NBC, initially Vernon Sanders, then Christelle Miller, Cerise Masakula, and last but not least, the Bruce Evans. Bruce. Thank you for being our champion. I have no idea where you are. Thank you for being our champion. Inside of Missy all this time, and for being such a trusted friend. Getting notes from you never felt like those. They were always beautiful and insightful observation and comments from the people who were as passionate about making the show and getting us to this point, getting us to 100 episodes as we were. We really felt it. And while I'm here, let me thank everyone at NBC. Everyone from Lens marketing team, to Chip's brilliant PR team, to Grace Roo and Kasten, thanks to Bob Greenblatt, Jim Salke, George Cheeks, Walter Leslie, Lisa Katz, Tracy Costa, for always finding a path with Peter and the dashing Red Ball, to keep the show going and going and going and going. We literally could not do it without you guys. To all our phenomenal directors, so many old pros, so many people whose first opportunity was on the show, but day to day, the people making the show are in this room tonight. They are our shooting crew in New York, led by Chad and Hillary, and our post team in LA, led by Sarah and Mike. There are too many of you to name. I was going to try to name every single person that had been here for 99 episodes, but that list is well over 50 names, which is insane that we've had that retention, you guys. But shout out to our departments. Accounting, art, ADs, camera, casting, catering, construction, costumes, craft services, electric, greens, grip, hair and makeup, our international shooting team, location, medics, post-production, scenic, our joint supervisors, set deck, sound, special effects, stunts, transportation, and VFX. Honestly, words fail me here, and I know that seems incredible because this is already way too long, but I don't think I can ever properly thank or bestow you the recognition you so dearly deserve. Thank you each and every one of you for giving so much of your life, your heart to the show over the past 5 years. This was not an easy show to make at any time. It was me. It was complicated. We were always trying to punch above our weight class. The hours were long. The circumstances were often less than ideal. But my greatest joy has been watching you all do what you do. Every single day, you made the show better. Each of you over-delivered in ways that have made this thing so much greater than the sum of its parts. Your immeasurable creativity on the floor, problem-solving, has been thrilling to witness. You are operating at such an incredibly high level. Most of the time when I'm directing here, I just sit and marvel at you all. And that's what I'm going to miss the most. I'm going to miss you guys. When it starts, you're all alone, and it's just you and an idea, but if you're lucky like I was, in the end, you find yourself surrounded by hundreds of beautiful artisans, artists and misfits who have brought an idea to beautiful shimmering lives. You all did this. You got us to 100 episodes. I'm so beyond grateful. I'm humbled and honored to have worked with you, each and every one of you. We will miss you terribly. Goodbye. I love you. I hope you get to do this again someday soon. The cast, would you please come up and join me? Let's cut this 100 episodes.